the budget fever has caught on for sure. Understandably, the BJP's resounding victory in the Lok Sabha elections has all sectors pinning high hopes from the upcoming budget. The banking and financial sector in particular is in dire need of reforms. We all know that the banking sector is one of the most vital sectors, essentially the lifeblood of the economy. Hence, a weak and ailing banking sector can derail the growth in the economy. Over the last 4 to 5 years, the dismal state of affairs at banks has been a growing cause for concern. For one, the credit growth has fallen sharply over the last 4 to 5 years. In fact, credit growth slipped to decadal low levels of 5% during this period. The overall slowdown in the economy has resulted in the slowdown in credit growth as well. However, the weak balance sheets of banks has further impeded credit growth. Sample this. Bad loans, which were at 4% of loans in FY14 when the Modi government first took charge, shot up to 13-14% levels. The sharp rise in bad loan provisioning has led to huge losses for public sector banks, eroding their capital. While the centre has infused massive amount of capital, especially in the last 2 to 3 years, it has gone mostly to absorb losses rather than fund growth. Public sector banks that constitute over 2/3 of the lending activity in the system have seen a very modest growth in loans. Over the last 5 years, their loan book has grown by only 6%. The IBC process, which was implemented over 2 years ago, has hit a roadblock. Excessive delays in the process is hurting banks. Add to the weak banking sector, the NBFC sector is also now in turmoil. We all know that NBFC has been playing a very vital role in filling the void in the credit demand of the economy. The government will first have to push forth structural reforms in the banking sector, granting more autonomy to bank boards, diluting their stake in public sector banks, and overhauling the governance structures will be very, very critical. We all know that the RBI's revised framework on resolution of stressed assets has now given banks more discretion to deal with their issue. But this would require bankers to take some hard-hitting decisions on haircuts and losses, which cannot come about if there is no governance overhaul in the public sector banks. While the government has kick-started the consolidation process within the sector by merging Bank of Baroda with Vijaya and Dena Bank, there has to be a more clear roadmap for consolidation. Consolidation in bank mergers cannot be triggered by weak financial state of affairs at small public sector banks. Rather than throwing good money after bad, the government will have to rethink its recapitalization strategy for the next 4 to 5 years. Ironing out the roadblocks in the IBC process and tackling the current NBFC crisis will be very, very critical. Above all, the government will have to kickstart reforms in the infrastructure space to revive the investment activity and the CapEx cycle. This will be imperative to boost the credit demand in the banking system.